But I lost one of my friends due to gang violence, so it was either I could go back, get the homies and kill them, or we could make something of ourselves. I went into a funeral dressed just like this. Of course, I got judged. The pastor looked at me like, you know, just some other black dude out here not knowing what he's doing with his life. In actuality, he didn't know. 2 months later, down the road, I was going to be winning 3 awards for a program that I started at the age of 15. So I did that. And, like, you know, I've been influenced a lot of kids. Like, a lot of kids come to me now, and I'm not bragging, but a lot of kids come to me and say they want to be like me, this, that, and the third. And I appreciate that for the simple fact I never thought at the age of 19 I could be somebody else's hero. Some other kid will walk up to me and say, I want to be like you, but I never had a father, I never had a mom. And I go to these schools and tell these kids, you can't use that as an excuse. Some kids look at it and think, because my mom and dad wasn't there, I could just use that as an excuse, like, oh, this is my excuse. So when my teachers say, why are you failing? Well, mom, you know, well, dad, I never had my mom and dad growing up. And because of that, that's the reason I'm failing. So I was wondering if you could look out for me on my grade. It doesn't work like that. And a lot of kids don't understand that. So when they hear it from an adult, they're like, man, this dude, oh. So when they see somebody like myself, I dress the same way when I go into these schools, and they see somebody like myself, they're like, okay, I'm going to listen to this dude for the fact he looks like me, dresses like me, talks like me. And we need more of that. We need more people my age that are willing to step up and say, man, stop that, or anything like mentoring these kids. I'm starting a mentoring program and everything. Like, that's what we need more.
Real Rap Radio for the purpose of entertainment. And what it turned into, 166,000 users in 24 countries pretty much following the site. So then I transformed it into a vehicle to where I did nothing but take it and take indie artists and give indie artists in every city and state a chance to be heard to a national, worldly audience without the middleman, without the record label, without all of that. You know, if you got your CDs online, the whole world will be able to hear it, build your fan base. They can just go straight to you. All of the DJs that are trying to come up, we feature, the whole site is based on, you can just go there. If you're having a party at home and you don't have a DJ, you can just go to Real Rap Radio and the DJ live stream for you right there. So it's a vehicle for all of the DJs to get onto the world platform. Just pretty much riding through Cleveland, just coming back home to just, you know, check everything out and give people the opportunity to get that world platform and just let y'all know that y'all don't have to, like, sit around and have this dream of signing with record labels and stuff like that, because you really don't want to be a main industry artist like that, because the whole agenda of the industry per se and the main industry is not really to, how can I put it, it's not to uplift the culture, it's really to bring down a culture and to get all of these kids coming up, you know, running around looking like Trinidad James. You know, that's really what it's all about. You know, I've been to a couple of music seminars and I've seen firsthand, you know, like really, really talented people get turned down for whatever the agenda of the record label is at that time. And the agenda is pretty much the same agenda as you see on these talk shows where they find the most ignorant black folks that they can find to, you know, to show to the world to say, like, you know, this is how they are. This is what they, it's the same thing with music. And music is pretty much, people think that slavery went away. But really, the plan, you need to really go, and if you've never heard or read the Slave Insulters Narrative by Willie Lynch, you really need to read that, because it's the same vehicle and the same formula that the industry is using in your music right now. So being an industry artist is not the key. My advice to all of you, and the reason why I created this radio station and this website, and the reason why the universe and God has allowed it to do as good as it's doing right now and go worldwide, is because it's time to just do you. You know what I'm saying? Just start doing you. Focus on the business aspect, the business side, because at the end of the day, your music is nothing but a product. So once you got your business thing down, even if you're independent, you know, if you're a sole proprietor, if you want to go get your LLC or whatnot, you know, it costs $100, just start the business end of it. Get your CDBaby.com account set up. Get your music on CDBaby, because when you do that with your $35 and you send your stuff to CDBaby, they give you all of the digital distribution in the world for free. I haven't been in a studio since 2004. I still get checks from CD Baby every month for music that I made in 2004. You know what I'm saying? I ain't never been in a studio since 2004. I still get checks every month from CD Baby, because they hook you up with your iTunes and every national digital distribution thing there is on the planet. And it's free just for signing up and setting up an account with. So that's something y'all need to know.
Also, Breakdancer.
and my man had his own phone box, and we were out rocking it, flipping and tripping off the ghetto cardboard. I love hip hop, and I take it real silly because man, great and tall. Ink pen paper, spray paint on can, with me on the wall. The DJ knew how to calm down the crowd and pump the crowd up as if he was a ringmaster in a circus. Move the crowd. Can I get a hoe? Amen. Can I get a hoe? Amen. The DJ was like the president and everybody listening. Move the crowd. I love hip hop and hip hop loves me. Thank you.
My name is Carmel. Well, my real name is Cressy, but they call me Carmel. My boy's like, go up, mommy, you a positive woman? Because I take care of man. I hold it down, I cook, I clean, I do everything I need to do for my family. I hold my man down, I do whatever it is. I'm a teacher, I make money, I do everything. So I feel like I was raised from a pop. My mother and my grandmother always taught me, be respectful for you. Sometimes it's so bad they call me bougie because I take care of me and ours. I make sure everything is paid for to zero balance to whatever. So I feel like every month y'all should idol a woman at least once a month.
Well, let's do this. I want everybody to stand up. Everybody in the room to stand up right now. And I want y'all to take a bow to the queen of the earth. Ladies and gentlemen, the queen of the earth.
Thank you.
Give us a round of applause. Thank you. And that's not bad about that comment, little lady, but it was Adam. And you talk about Michael just the way you talk about it. Why Kruger is just amazing. You talk about that. And also, when the Kruger was talking about the queen, they were talking about how we already know how organized some supposed certain streets. But they just don't matter. But you better mind, it's not all Kruger's fault. But you stay on the plantation, you're on the plantation. You might be a sharecropper, you might live here and work somewhere else. But the same mentality, psychological slavery. There's entertainment from KRS-One, entertainment. The people of hip hop, to keep in mind that we are hip hop, and hip hop is good. The first element of hip hop, I play around the world. We put it down here. Now, I tell this around the world. The first element of hip hop, because I was there, is the spiritual element, it's the God element. To put that